So, a traditional Jewish, Christian, and Muslim...
...to understand atheist and agnostic as well as many...
Russell's teapot is this idea that there is a teapot orbiting the planets between Earth and Mars, or the Moon and Mars.
Close. It's what? Not orbiting a planet. It's just chilling out
just chilling
between,
out between
Earth and Mars.
Earth and Mars. Yeah. I thought it was moving.
Doesn't. I mean, I'm sure it moves. Move. Both Earth and Mars move.
And this is the start of the commentary on religion and burden of proof. It's used a lot in, I mean, I guess arguments for atheism and agnosticism is that you can't disprove that there isn't a teapot between Earth and Mars.
Right. So, and I don't have to prove that there is.
Right? So this is where when we talk about burden of proof, it falls on, the note I found says, it falls on the believer, not in this case the atheist, to prove that there is a teapot, right? You can't just say, well, you can't disprove that there's no teapot.
Right.
No, you have to prove that there's a teapot.
And that's the exact way that our legal system works out. If you want to accuse somebody of something, it's not up to them to prove that they didn't do it. It's up to you to prove they did.
That they did, yeah.
And so that same principle applies here, that it's not up to the atheists and agnostics to find any evidence that there's no God. It's up to everybody who believes that he exists to prove it if they want to have this argument.
Yeah, or whatever you believe exists.
Yeah.
Peace be with you.
By the late Middle Ages, the Christian prophecies have fulfilled itself.